Hey guys, today for the review, we have the WEP 948DQ-I. We received this fume and smoke extractor from the WEP Tools company to make a review. It's the WEP 948DQ-I Fume Extractor. Let's unbox it and check out its features. This product comes with an instruction manual, 4 front carbon filters, 4 rear carbon filters, a pair of fenders, and a pair of helping hands. Attach the helping hands on each side of the extractor. The helping hands are a pair of adjustable clips to grab components, wires, circuit boards, and other small objects. They are used to secure your components in place while you solder or desolder them. Attach the fenders to each side of the extractor. These fenders help direct airflow toward the front, where your component is located. Align the ridge on the extractor to the groove on the fender. Apply a bit of pressure and push down. Do the same on the other side. The curve end is on the top. 4 front carbon filters are included. Remove one and insert it into the front of the extractor. Four rear carbon filters are included. Take one out and place it into the extractor. Press the switch to turn on the extractor. Let's see this extractor in action. I'm going to attach a capacitor to this PCB. Secure the PCB to the helping hands. Turn on the extractor. Now I'm going to turn on the soldering station. I will add some solder wire to secure the capacitor in place. I don't smell the solder fumes. The extractor seems to be doing its job. This time, let's do some desoldering. I'm going to remove this capacitor from the PCB. Secure the PCB by attaching the clips on both sides. Turn on the extractor. Make sure to adjust the helping hands so they are very close to the extractor. I'm going to turn on the desoldering station. Let's remove this capacitor. This extractor does a great job pulling the solder fumes away from my work area. I don't smell the fumes while soldering or desoldering the components. Make sure you have the component close to the extractor. The link to this extractor is in the video description. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.